Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go into Visual Basic and show you how to use an if statement that has more than one criteria that you are trying to evaluate. So this is known as the if statement with an and. So let's say I have an Excel spreadsheet here, and I want to evaluate for two different conditions. First of all, I want to evaluate whether or not my project status in B1 is complete. And second, I want to evaluate for whether or not the income I've generated is over $30,000. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So the first thing I want to do here is I want to press Function Alt F11, and this will bring me to the Visual Basic for Applications window. Now, once I'm in the window, I need to be able to have somewhere to write my code. So what I would like to do is create a module. So I'm going to go up here to Insert and go to Module. And I can see that I get a blank screen right here where I can begin writing. So the first thing I want to do is I want to create a subprocedure called Commission. So I can do that by writing the word sub, and then I'm going to write Commission. And just a couple things about these two statements here. Sub is a reserved word by Excel, so you have to have that. But the word commission can be very flexible. So I can use any word that I want here as long as it's a one word altogether and it doesn't have spaces in it. So if I hit enter, you can see that VBA has already put the end sub in there for me. So I'm going to hit tab so that my code just becomes a little bit more readable. So let's go back to the Excel spreadsheet for a minute. I'm just going to click Alt Tab to get back there. So if I look here, I can see that B1 has my status and B2 has the amount of income generated. So I'm going to Alt Tab back to VBA. And let's talk about cells B1 and B2 there. So the first thing I'm going to type is if range with a left parenthesis and a double quote. And I'm going to put B1 and close my quotes and close my parentheses, because B1 is where I'm storing the status. So I'm going to say if that equals complete, and I have to put complete in double quotes, then I'm going to put the word then and then hit enter. And then I'm going to indent. And if this is complete, I'm going to return a message box to the user. So that's going to be MSGBOX with a left parenthesis and a double quote. And let's just say here, commission earned, and my quotes and my parentheses. And then if I hit enter, I'm just going to backspace here and I'm going to type end if, because if I begin an if statement, I have to have an end if at the end of it. But if you notice here, I am only evaluating for what's in B1. And that's okay because we're going to add a condition in a couple minutes. So if I Alt Tab back to Excel and I go to View and I go over here to Macros and I run Commission, nothing happens because my project status is still in progress. However, if I go to B1 and I type Complete and click out of there and then run my macro again, I can see that I am getting a message that says Commission Earned. So how about we Alt Tab back to VBA and add to this a little bit.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So I'm going to put an else statement in here. So after this parenthesis, I'm going to hit enter and backspace and do an else. Hit enter and tab in and do message box again with the left parenthesis and then a double quote and do no commission earned. Close my quotes, close my parentheses. And then I'm going to Alt Tab back to Excel. And let's change this to in progress again. Click out of there and run my macro again by clicking macros, run. And I can see no commission was earned because this is not complete. However, if I change this back to complete, hit enter, run this again, I am getting the commission earned message box. But now we have to account for what is in B2. So if I Alt Tab back to VBA, I'm going to click right before the then here, and I'm just going to type and, And this time, let's get the range of B2. Don't forget to enclose that in quotes and then parentheses. And then let's say that is greater than 30,000, then we want the commission earned. So let's go back and test these several scenarios. So let's say I only have 10,000 in income generated right here. It's complete, but I only have 10,000. If I click macros and hit run for commission, I have no commission earned because I only met one criteria. But let's say I generated $31,000 and I run the macro, the commission is earned. But what if I put this back to in process? My commission should not be earned, and that is correct. So I need both cases here to be true, what is in B1 and B2 to be evaluated, and that's where the and comes in. So if you are working with Excel, and this is one of the first macros you're writing, one thing you want to be careful of is when you go up to File, and you go to Save As, and I'm going to hit Browse, you want to make sure that the type right here is saved as an Excel macro-enabled workbook. And you can tell if it is, if it's .xlsm on the end instead of the xlsx. And you do have to pick this option for Excel to know that this is a workbook that has a macro in it. So just make sure when you go to save that, that you are saving it as an Excel macro-enabled workbook. Otherwise, you'll lose your changes. So hopefully that shows you how you can write a macro where you return a message box to the user whether the threshold for the commission has been reached or not. We go into this a little bit more in depth on our blog, so I will include the link to that below in the description on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotion and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.